State of the Nation.
Zimbabwe is about to launch a satellite. Yes, you heard that right. What does this mean? Are we sending a rocket to the moon? Are we planning on going to Mars like Elon Musk? Or what? With all the issues that we have, why are we even talking about going to space? Do we need a satellite? What is it for? In fact, wait a minute. First things first, what is a satellite anyway? What does all this mean? Well, it's not really as complicated as it sounds. Let's try to break this down. Now, Zimbabwe is indeed launching a satellite. It's called ZimSat-1. Cool name, right? But what is this all about? First, why do countries send these satellites into space? This is where it gets a bit more interesting. We will talk about what ZimSat-1 is supposed to do in a moment. But basically, satellites are there for a lot of reasons. The big one is communication. They send and receive messages. With a satellite, we can communicate easier. We can monitor the weather and the land. 4,852. That's the number of satellites that were floating in space at the start of the year. These are from different countries. Of these almost 5,000 satellites, the US owned almost 3,000 of them. What about African countries? In Africa, there are at least 10 countries that now have their own satellites in space. South Africa was the first in 1999. Kenya launched in 2018, and our neighbor Zambia plans its own launch in 2023. African countries have over 40 satellites in space right now. Why do they need them? Here's one example. Recently, there was a locust swarm near the Sahara Desert. Scientists used satellite images to see where the locust swarms were breeding. They were able to prevent the locusts from swarming, the safe crops in large parts of the region. This is what they call remote sensing. It sounds complicated, but simply, this is a way of looking at a large area of land to see what's going on there in terms of weather and other changes. From space, we can see what is happening to our forests and protect the environment. So, what about Zimbabwe? What are we doing? Well, to answer this, we must start here at the Zimbabwe National Geospatial and Space Agency, or ZINGSA. This is what we may call Zimbabwe's space and science hub. We saw the president launching the agency not too long ago. Are we sending our men and women to the moon? Well, not quite yet. It is more practical than we think. ZINGSA is using satellite images to do a lot of stuff. Number one, remember the five ecological regions we all learned in school? Region 2 gets a lot of rain, so it's good for crops such as maize. Region 5 is dry, so it's good for cattle ranching, tourism, and so forth. Well, the problem is that these maps were drawn up between 1945 and 1960. Climate change has changed all that, so we need to update these maps. Using satellite imagery, our scientists have now done just that. This is useful for planning land use programs for specific regions. What else is ZINGSA doing? They have come up with a National Wetlands Master Plan. This is a map of all our wetlands. This was done through ZINGSA's Geospatial Science and Earth Observation Department. When we know where our wetlands are, we can protect them better. There is more about ZINGSA's work. Again, using satellites, they have been mapping urban settlements around the country. This includes Jimboki Farm in Mutare, Cowdery Park in Bulawayo, and Caledonia in Harare. Many other settlements are being mapped. That way, we can have better knowledge about the state of urban and rural settlements in the country. This helps us to plan better. Climate change is a reality. The weather is getting more and more unpredictable. The tools that we used years ago to monitor the weather need changing. This is why satellites are important in tracking weather patterns. The Met Department can be able to use satellites to make more accurate weather predictions. We can see how clouds are moving. Forecasts can be more localized. This is good news for our farmers. With climate change, we're getting more and more climate disasters. We all remember Cyclone Idai. With satellites, we can manage natural disasters a lot better. Think of how important satellite images will be if there's a flood. We can predict storms and floods, and we can respond better because we can see the hardest hit areas. This will save lives. So this is the work that ZINGSA is already doing. This has been achieved using satellites from other countries. We had to pay space on those satellites. Now, Zimbabwe has been working on its own satellite. As many as 20 local scientists from our local universities have been involved. They are from Bindura University of Science Education, University of Zimbabwe, Midland State University, and Chinoy University of Technology. Are they building a spacecraft? Well, at least not yet. What they have worked on is what's called a nanosatellite. This is a very small cube. It weighs no more than 10 kilograms. It's a major achievement for our scientists who work very hard with very little resources. Because no African country has launch capacity, African countries rely on other countries to do that for us. ZimSat 1 will launch from a Japanese launch system. By the redrawing of our ecological maps and mapping wetlands, our scientists at ZingSa have already shown us what they can do. With ZimSat 1, they will be able to do more. Across Africa, more and more countries are investing in satellites. The African Union has come up with the African Space Strategy to guide member states on why it's important for them to invest in this technology. This is what the AU says. The space sector is not only a high-end technology sector, but also provides the tools required for effective decision-making in the management of our natural resources and providing essential communications. Space is not really about what we see in the movies. It's a lot more basic than that. No, we are not yet going to plant the Zimbabwean flag on the moon. At least, not yet. What Zimbabwe is doing is what many other countries are doing, investing in technology to support development today and for the future. Like, share, comment, and subscribe.